colleague of yours is about to be interred.
Yeah, well, I found out some interesting facts about that. Your man in Islamabad, he had a rep of not exactly being a team player.
Him, you, half the people here. The whole agency's full of prima donnas.
Yeah, well, he had a particular reason. Sandy had a dark asset providing targeting information on terrorists in the border region. Until the wedding party, it was good information. It was genius information, in fact, on people we'd been unable to locate for years. Now suddenly they were in our sights and we were taking them out, one after the next. It was getting him a lot of praise.
So?
It was getting you a lot of praise, too. Which is why you didn't want to hear how your golden boy was doing it. That he was out there trading top secret information to God knows who in exchange for a few successful drone strikes.
I know who you've been talking to. Harris.
Right. Harris flew all the way back from Islamabad to tell you in person what was happening. You knew what was going on there. That makes you complicit.
In what?
It's called treason. There are laws against it, and they apply to everyone, even the director of the CIA.
Get a grip. I'm not complicit in anything. We're talking about a judgment call.
A judgment call that got a wedding blown up, a station chief killed. Those hearings that you're worried about, they are not going to go better in light of these facts.
What do you want?
What I said before, I want Islamabad.
It's impossible. I already told the president you're coming back to Langley.
You need to listen to me. I am not staying here.
Pakistan, why do you even want to go back to that shithole?
Yes or no?
It's not even a real country. It's a fucking acronym.